Ryan Zimmerman of the United States skated, did not skate well. They have set the standard. And here is a team in its first year together. And already European champions, Maria Petrova and Alexei Tikhonov of Russia.
Just gotten together 6 months ago, a lot like our Canadian team, Jamie Soleil and David Pelletier. They just instantly hit it off. And here is the throw, triple toe loop, and she doubles. Came down early.
much better than the short program. And they're happy about it. Heads above the short program for Petrova and Tikhonov. Their marks after this. Alexei Tikhonov with his partner Maria Petrova, new partnership this season, won the European Championships. Those whistles, by the way, are whistles of derision. Those are boos in Russia. Some of the fans not happy with the marks. But Petrova and Tikhonov, the leaders right now, Ina and Zimmerman skating earlier, are second. Here's the team to watch and the team to beat. Chinese champions, recently crowned four continents champions, had to fly all the way from Halifax, where they won that four continents title last weekend, to St. Petersburg, as did Tatiana Malinina, but maybe that's good luck, who knows, the way Tatiana skated. Here is Zhuo Shen, Hongbo Zhao, leaders after the short program.
They've improved so much this season in their confidence. And they have a much better package overall. They have far better choreography, better connections in between the elements. Side-by-side triples to open. You see such a difference here in the power, in the speed between the teams we have just seen and this team. And look at that explosive triple twist. To throw triple loop, this just flies. Second throw, the Sal Cow. She is just so over top of those jumps. Skating to the soundtrack from the movie Mulan.
at the Worlds, they just missed out a podium finish. In a few weeks in Helsinki,
they will be... and Sikorlitsi have a major task ahead of them here.
They will be one of the teams to beat. Berezhnaya and Sikorlitsi still escape in Russia. The Chinese champions, two wins this season, one in the Skate Canada Championship, the other at Four Continents, both coming in Canada. Can they fly? They need a parachute.
Unbelievable. Here's this overhead lift, the lasso lift that I love so much. They possess such confidence that they really set the viewer at ease, because you have complete confidence in what they're doing.
And again, our thanks to ABC for providing the pictures tonight. And folks, I know television is the next best thing to watching it live, but you have to see these two live. It's incredible. They had 2 seconds this year in the Grand Prix circuit, both at the hands of Berezhnaya and Sikorlitsi, a team they have never beaten. Those marks put them in first place. And now they will wait to see if they can indeed knock off the world champions. And wouldn't that be a burst of confidence heading towards Helsinki?
And doesn't that set up a great world championship?
Wow. Because the world champions who are on the ice did not skate like world champions. If you watched this earlier today, the short program, Elena Berezhnaya, Anton Sikorlitsi. Elena did not look well. She did not look focused. She did not look healthy. They were lucky to be in second place.
And I don't look like her look right now. She's looking like she really doesn't want to be there. She doesn't have any fire in her eyes. Twist. not put them in a great frame of mind going to the World Championships.
You have to wonder if there are any lingering effects from the illness that Elena had, the flu, at the European Championships. They were forced to withdraw, and you can see Anton with some concern on his face looking at his partner. They do not want this to be a harbinger of the World Championships. Two programs in a row that clearly were not World Championship caliber from Berezhnya and Sigurlitsy.
Had problems with, she's off in the air and goes right over her toe pick. We've seen that a few times here this evening, way too far forward. And here's the lift. Watch, her foot is supposed to go between his shoulder and his head. But I think he sees the blade coming straight for his face. She can't get it in there, so he has to bring her down.
Oh, that was
fear,
very
look
close.
At her shoulders there, for fear of getting the blade in the face.
Now, keep in mind, for those of you who don't know, that a few years ago, Elena, with a previous partner, suffered an on-ice training accident during side-by-side camel spins where her partner's skate blade slashed her head and it was even embedded in her skull. She was very lucky to be alive. So being sick, perhaps, is nothing to her, and she would go out and skate. Maybe that's not the
under
frame of
condition.
Mind. Yeah. But what will happen here for sure, folks, is that the Chinese team is going to win this event. We still have one pair to skate, of course. But the Chinese may have sent a message for the World Championships.
And I think also we have to be concerned that, you know, we hope that she's back on track for the World Championships here.
There's Tamara Moskvina, their coach, one of the organizers of this event in St. Petersburg. You hope it is a physical thing and not a mental thing. A focus thing 3 weeks before the World Championships. Everybody has prepared this team.
This is a confidence-shattering performance. We really hope that she can get it back together.
But everyone has always said this team could be a dynasty in pairs, but not so sure. 5.9.
Canada.
Well, the presentation is on.
No, the presentation was marred by all the mistakes.
They do have some great flow, but yes, on this night, they were not as they have been in the past. And again, their marks hold up. The Canadian judge gives them a first place. And that clearly is a miss. Berezhnya and Sigurlitsy, their marks were held up after the short program. And they had a lot of errors and miscues. We'll see what happens. Last pair team on the ice. Third after the short program. They would absolutely have to have the performance of their life to win, but they are in line for a medal. Sarah Abitbol and Stéphane Bernardy.
And clearly they should have been above Berezhnya and Sigurlitsy. In the short, they were clean. Position on that star lift.
Certainly a strange night in St. Petersburg in the pair's event.
A tough cold is a
Grand Prix final in St. Petersburg, but that has slipped away.
Some very unusual errors, like the fall going into the spin. They completely missed the spin, and that is just something that you don't see very often at this level.
Their marks will drop them a notch. They will finish fourth. Biggest jump of the night to the other Russian team, Petrova and Tikhonov. They will win the bronze medal. Barishnaya Sigarlytsi will take silver. A lot of concern in this building whether this team is okay. Zhuo Shen and Hongbo Zhao of China upset the world champions for the first time. They have beaten them. Elena Barishnaya has sought some medical attention. And according to some in St. Petersburg, she's okay. So they're going to have to regroup for the world championships. $50,000 to the Chinese team, Kyoko Ina and John Zimmerman of the United States.